All right, so track, I started my track career in sophomore year, so 2015. I always wanted to run track as a kid just because I had family members that had run track. So just kind of doing that. And then playing baseball was kind of hard, running track and playing baseball, being in the same season. And you know, after baseball, I had moved to a different school, and then it was after like the cuts with baseball, so track was the only sport to play. And I just, that's when I got into it and really took it seriously. So when I got to Honda, I felt like I really grew as a person in the classroom, out the classroom, on the track, and off the track. So I just felt like at that whole 18 months I was there, I grew a lot. And then that really molded me coming to LSU, because I feel like LSU, it's like, it's crazy, you know, it's like a, it's kill or be killed, you know, it's just so competitive. So I think, you know, coming to LSU, then I already had that mentality and I had the talent, so you went those two together, which is kind of like a match made in heaven. So I think in JUCO, it's just kind of, you have to grow up, you know, things aren't handed to you, you know, you don't have your parents there to, I'll cook your food or, you know, get you food or talk to your professors, you know, like in high school, you know, they talk to your counselor, or when you're at D1, you have, you know, your coaches, but you know, everything you have to do for yourself. So everything you get is what you put in, you know, there's no handouts, there's no extra treatment, you know, everybody gets treated the same. You know, you could have been a Olympian before you came there, or you could have been, you know, a high school state champion, whatever. Once you get there, you're just another, you know, track and field athlete. So I think you have to earn your respect. And I think that's one thing that I really admire, because then when I came to LSU, you know, at a very powerhouse D1, you know, a lot of stuff is given to us because we work hard, but I still keep that same mentality in JUCO as I do at LSU, and I feel like that's why I'm able to reach higher levels just from that mentality. So I think in the 200, I think it's just, a lot of people don't know how to run it, and I think that I've mastered how to run it, you know, distributing my energy, not really working hard the first 100, because you can't sprint the whole race. So I think, you know, running that first turn is kind of just like, it's almost like a warm-up, you know, running the first turn. I'm not really running 100%, you know, I'm kind of seeing, you know, feeling my competition, and, you know, once I feel like I'm being passed or I sense it, I kind of, it's kinda almost like I'm scared, and I just, you know, just take off. And then, you know, what Coach Shaver tells me, relax and sprint, so then I'm relaxing sprinting that last 100 meters, and while everybody else, you know, they're just, you know, tightening up and not really trusting their mechanics, I feel like that's when I really separate. I think in the 100, it's just being about aggressive the first and 30 meters, you know, because I'm gonna run fast the last 60 just because of my top end speed. So I think being aggressive the first 30 and kind of winning from the gun, you know, because I've never been that type of sprinter that I win from the blocks. You know, my block starts aren't the best in the world, and they're not the worst in the world, but it's not, that's not my race plan. So I think just incorporating into my race plan, being, you know, pushing and really driving and really winning from the gun is something that teaches me that I can, you know, be more proficient in the 100, so that when I go to the 200, the faster I'm running the first 100, then obviously, you know, the faster I can run the second 200 as I get better as the race goes on. I think, you know, in the 4x1, it's just, if I'm behind, I'm gonna catch whoever's in front. I'm gonna figure out a way to catch somebody in front. And if I'm in the lead, I just feel that, you know, I don't feel like anybody in the country can beat me with a baton, but especially if I'm ahead, but if we're getting even. So I think, you know, it's just kind of, you know, it's kill or be killed, who wants it more. And I think that every time I get the stick, I'm gonna do everything I can to put us in the lead and, you know, to score points at nationals or SECs or at a meet, and also, you know, run the best time we can possibly run. So I think just going to Eugene, it's a big business trip, but it's also kind of a learning experience, because being at that such a, I think, big level, it's kind of what's to come, you know, in the next couple of years, you know, being maybe a professional athlete, you know, future endeavors within track and field. So I think just going there is just kind of starting in the right direction, you know, not going there and not letting that moment and that pressure build up and, you know, take away from my performances, you know, and push me in backwards. So I think just going there, scoring as much points as I can for my team at nationals, and then at trials, obviously just doing the best I can and just using that momentum to get better and better. When you train with great athletes and people that are at the top of their game in their event, it's just like, well, if I'm not doing the same, I feel like, you feel like an outsider. You don't feel like you fit in. So there's only one way to fit in. It's just to work hard and do the, you know, do the best you can, because we all have the talent to be the best. It just comes to what we do daily, you know, hydration, eating properly, you know, doing things outside the track, you know, focusing on the things that we can control and doing those the best that we can.